In this video, we'll talk about stoichiometric calculations. Stoichiometric calculation problems are the problems where you find the quantity of one substance from the quantity of another substance. There are actually two different ways to solve these, and I'll try to show you both ways. Let's first try to understand what is given and what is asked. It says complete combustion of some pentane gave 4.4 grams of carbon dioxide. So it says grams, I know the mass of carbon dioxide. It's asking me to calculate the mass of combusted pentane. So I know the mass of carbon dioxide to be 4.4 grams and I need to find the mass of C5H12. Let's first write the equation for this reaction. What do I know in this equation? I know the mass of carbon dioxide. And what do I need? I need the mass of pentane. So in the first method, I'll try to set a proportion between the mass of 1 mole of pentane and mass of 5 moles of carbon dioxide. Now, mass of 1 mole of pentane is easy to find. Carbon is 12, so it's going to be 5 times 12 plus hydrogen is 1, so 1 times 12. If you calculate this, you'll find it as 72 grams. So mass of 1 mole of this one is 72 grams. Then it will correspond to mass of 5 moles of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is carbon which has a mass of 12 and 2 oxygens, it is 2 times 16. If you calculate it, you'll find it to be 44. I have 5 moles of it produced, so it's going to be 5 times 44. 72 grams of pentane gives me 5 times 44 grams of carbon dioxide. So how many grams of it will give me? 4.4 grams. So from here, you'll find it x as 72 times 4.4 divided by 5 times 44. Then if you make your calculation, you'll find the answer as 1.44 grams. There is a second method for solution of this. In this second method, you can use the formulas. What you can do is that from the given mass of carbon dioxide, you can find the mole number of carbon dioxide, then you can find the mole number of the required compound, C5H12, and after you find the mole number of that, you can find the mass of C5H12. So you can solve this question in 1, 2, 3 steps. So the first step is to find the mole number of carbon dioxide from each mass. Mole number of carbon dioxide will be mass divided by molar mass. Mass is given to be 4.4 grams. We have calculated the molar mass to be 44, so it's going to be 44 grams per mole. It is going to be 0.1 mole. Then the second step will be to find the mole number of pentane from the mole number of carbon dioxide. As you see, the relationship between pentane's mole number and carbon dioxide's mole number is 1 to 5. So pentane's mole number is 5 times less. So I'll say that mole number of C5H12 is equal to mole number of carbon dioxide divided by 5. So it's going to be 0.1 mole divided by 5. It's going to be 0.02 mole. And the final step is to find the mass of our required compound, pentane, from its mole number. Mass of pentane, C5H12, is equal to mole number times its molar mass. Mole number is 0.02 mole, we found it here, times molar mass of it, we have found it here, if you remember, 72 grams per mole. When you multiply them, you'll find the same answer, 1.44 grams. You can use this method or that method, whichever it is easier for you. That's all for this video.